We're tracking the showers and thunderstorms across the valley. Hi there, meteorologist TJ Springer here in the Weather Center for an update on what's currently happening and what we could see through the remainder of the afternoon. Going out, you'll want to stay weather aware. We've upgraded our impact day to an alert day because of that chance for a few stronger storms. We can see in Lancaster, glancing off to the southwest, the ominous view as these storms have ignited ahead of this cold front that's continuing to work eastbound as we speak. The downpours all around the Susquehanna Valley on Super Doppler 8. Plenty of lightning, ongoing flash flood warnings for some of the region right now, and all this slowly working in from the west to the east, and we'll start to see more coverage as we head through the remainder of the afternoon into the early evening. We can see along the I-83 corridor plenty of heavy rain. We have those flash flood warnings for parts of the Lehigh Valley, some of Berks County under a flash flood warning as well, and some of Juniata and Perry County up into Northumberland County under flash flood warnings. And we can see some of this rain starting to move into Lancaster County now, some of the areas that haven't seen as much rain thus far today. Now, as we look off across the area in terms of our last 6 hours, rainfall amounts have definitely exceeded a couple of inches in some spots and likely getting between maybe 3 to as much as 5 inches in some localized areas. And that's why we're seeing these ongoing flash flood warnings that will continue to stay in effect as long as this heavy rain is coming down. In the past 24 hours, we can see Gettysburg has already picked up close to 2 inches, none officially in Lancaster yet, or Lebanon, with Chambersburg bringing in at just over 6,500s. And we're likely going to see a lot more added to these totals as we progress through the remainder of our Sunday. We do have severe thunderstorm watches that are in effect for a good chunk of the region. These have actually been dropped for a few of our counties now as that severe weather threat starts to fade. We become more stable with the heavy rain, but there is still some sunshine that's peaked out, some instability across our southeastern locales. So that's where we're going to have to watch for maybe some stray stronger storms through the remainder of the early afternoon. But flooding is our big concern. We have those flood watches in effect until 10 o'clock. For most of the area, for the potential of not just flash flooding, but low-lying areas, low-lying flood-prone regions, rivers, creeks, streams could outrun their banks as well through the remainder of the day. So what are we expecting? I've kind of hit the nail on the head thus far. Torrential rain, flooding, the potential for strong and severe storms. That's why we have an alert day early from now through 6 o'clock. As the storms continue to move from really south to north, kind of southeast to north, or southwest rather, to northeast, as this cold front continues to work in from the west. Actually hearing a little bit of thunder, it sounds like, here at the station. Rainfall rates, 1 to 3 inches an hour possibly, and that's why we're getting that flooding threat. Gusty wind, the big concern with all the moisture in the air. The hail is a lesser threat, the tornadic threat also becoming lower. We thought that was a little higher earlier on in the morning when we had that warm front lifting in. But gusty wind, that's a big concern, as well as the heavy rain, as all of this moisture is falling from the sky. We can get some of this wind to rush out of these storms as well. So that's why we could see some gusty wind concerns through the remainder of our Sunday fun day. Here's our 24-hour forecast. We'll keep the alert period through 3, really through 6, as long as those severe thunderstorm watches are in effect. But I'm thinking we're going to keep the impact going through the overnight because of some residual flooding that is a possibility. Even if the rain starts to taper off, still could have some flooding, some outrunning of local rivers, creeks, and streams. So make sure you stay weather aware. We're going to keep you ahead of all this. Keep tabs on all of our social media accounts as well as the WGAL app, because you can have the radar in the palm of your hand, get those alerts right to your phone if you have plans to head out and about. Once again, we don't have News 8 at 6 because of the Women's U.S. Open. So keep tabs on WGAL.com and again the app for the latest.